Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, again we go back to Sahih al-Bukhari, he told us Salatul Layl, Mathna, Mathna. That the night prayer is done in two and two. He didn't say 10 rak'ah, he didn't say 20, he didn't say 11, he didn't say 23. What did he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say? He says it's done in two and two. That's the only thing he told us. Yani if somebody prays less or more, there is no limit given to this. Unlike the sunan of Fajr or Dhuhr, or yani when you look at Jum'ah or any of these salawat, Rasulullah told us how many rak'at to pray in that. But here, Qiyam al-Layl, whether in Ramadan or outside, he left it at, it's done two by two. What did Rasulullah do himself? We go back to Imam al-Bukhari Sahih in the same bab, the bab of Taraweeh. Aisha radiallahu anha, she was asked, إِنَّهَا سَأَلَ عَيْشَة رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهَا كَيْفَ كَانَتْ صَلَاةُ الرَّسُولُ صَلَّى اللَّهُ وَسَلَّمُ فِي الرَّمَضَانِ. So this is not about general Qiyam al-Layl. This is specifically about Ramadan. She was asked about that, and this is in the Bab al-Taraweeh in Sahih al-Bukhari. فَقَالَتْ فَكَانَ يَزِيد فِي الرَّمَضَانِ وَلَا فِي غَيْرِهَا عَلَى أَحَدْ عَشَرَ رَكَعَ. He did not increase in Ramadan or outside of it more than 11 rak'at. In Ramadan and outside of it. Taraweeh or Qiyam al-Layl, anytime. Aisha radiyallahu anha in Sahih al-Bukhari, she has narrated that he did not make more than 11 rak'at. There is no Sahih hadith that can match, even come close to this, to say that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made 20 rak'at. What we know from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Sahih al-Bukhari, from an authentic hadith from Aisha radiyallahu anha, that his taraweeh, his qiyam al-layl in Ramadan was 11 rak'at. Tayyib. So now the question comes to be, is making 20 rak'ah a bid'ah? No. Why? Because we go to the book Muwatta Imam Malik. And in the Muwatta Imam Malik, he has a bab, and it is the bab Kitab al-Salah fi Ramadan. Yani this is Qiyam al-Layl for Ramadan, which is what we call Taraweeh. And in this bab, he has a number of ahadith. And I want to show these in order first. Just the order of the ahadith. Tayyib. The first hadith, which is hadith 253 here. It is reported from Imam Malik, from Muhammad ibn Yusuf, from Sahib ibn Yazid. Only these two links between him and Umar ibn Khattab. فأمر عمر بن خطاب رضي الله عنه أبي بن كعب وتميم الداري رضي الله عنهما أن يقوم للناس بأحد عشر ركعة. عمر رضي الله عنه, what did he do? He saw the people that they had separated. They were making salah by themselves. He gathered them behind أبي بن كعب and تميم الداري رضي الله عنهما. Like we have two imams taking turns here. He had the same way. He had these two imams leading. And he had them lead the people with 11 rak'at. Some people say Umar radiyan made 20 and he didn't do 11. The hadith is there in the same book before it. In the next hadith we find, which is 254, Umar radiyallahu anhu kana al-nas yaqoom fi zaman Umar ibn Khattab fi Ramadan bi 23 rak'ah. He led the people with 23 rak'ah. The next hadith gives an explanation why between the two numbers. And that is that the Qari'a yaqra'a Surah Al-Baqarah fi thaman al-raka'at, in 8 raka'ah, they used to read all of Baqarah. So it became difficult on the people. Al-Hafidh Ibn Abdul Barr Al-Maliki, he said that what this means is that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made 11 raka'ah. Abu Bakr's time, they made 11 raka'ah. In Umar radiyallahu anhu's time, they also made 11 rak'ah. He gathered the people in one jama'ah, as was done in the lifetime of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But when it became difficult, when it became too long for the older people, for the weaker people, then he increased the number of rak'at, so you would get breaks. And that's where the name Taraweeh came from. He made it 23 rak'ah because Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't say Taraweeh or Qiyam al-Layl for Ramadan is 11 rak'ah or 10 or 23. He said mathna mathna, 2-2. So, looking at the condition of the people, Umar Radian, he increased it to 23 rak'ah, and there's nothing wrong with that because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, عَلَيْكُمْ بِسُنَّةِ وَسُنَّةُ الْخُلَفَاءِ الرَّاشِدِينَ الْمَهْدِينَ. So what does that tell you? First thing, what is clear from the fi'l, qawl, and iqrar al-Nabi alayhi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is making qiyam al-layl in jama'ah, which is called taraweeh, is a sunnah. Second thing, the best way and the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the only thing established from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and from Abu Bakr and Umar is 11 rak'at. Whoever can do this, alhamdulillah, there is no problem with this. It's clear from Al-Bukhari and from the Muwatta Imam Malik that if Sahaba did it, nobody objected to it, great. If you see your community that it's hard on them to make long rak'at, if you increase it to 23 rak'ah, nothing wrong with that. All of the madahib allowed it, nothing wrong with that. If you want to do more than that, like Imam Malik with 39 rak'ah and others, aqwal, nothing wrong with that, as long as you make it 2 by 2 and you end with witr with a single rak'ah. Tell you, all of this is fine. If you do it 11 rak'ah, this is the best. Why? Because this is what Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam did, but they were long rak'ah. If you break it up, like in the later time of Umar and the time Khilafah of Ali and Uthman and since then and what happened in the Haram till today, no problem with that, alhamdulillah, all of that is fine. Those that call each other mubtadi'a for doing this and some people that fight too much about this, this is out of ignorance, and we hope that in the light of these sahih ahadith, this issue is cleared up. Jazakumullahu khair.
شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصم ومن كان مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد بكم العسر ولتكملوا العدة ولتكبروا الله على ما هداكم ولعلكم تشكرون.